I'm Walter De Mesa.
I'm Carefulming Tuan.
Your guide to
places,
people, scenes,
and steals that dare you to live your best life.
So raise the bar.
Live the high life.
Here on this day. We have about 7,000 unique islands to choose from, and it's always a pleasure to explore them by sailing the seas. Once the anchors are lifted and you're lulled by the waves, there's no better place to watch the world go by. And when aboard one of these, you can consider your sea legs relaxed at the lap of luxury. This 46-foot beauty is a Tiki Waram catamaran. Now she goes by the name Naya and serves as a floating gateway to the country's most stunning destinations coming from the beaches of La Isla Batangas.
Basically, Naya Yacht is a charter yacht, meaning that anybody who wishes to go somewhere and experience a journey across the water, they can charter the yacht for an hour, a day, a week, or a month. In the Philippines, we don't have too many big waves, so most of the water is fairly flat. A catamaran allows you to stay flat even with a little chop. It gives you a very smooth sail. It's got much more space than a conventional sailing yacht.
And while it would be great to sit back and enjoy the ride, I think I'd have a better deal in this trip if I played skipper. But before I could take the wheel, it's best to know exactly what I'm driving.
The bow is basically the front of the yacht. It's the bit that hits the water first when you're moving forward. The bow is where the action is. So we have a trampoline at the front that you can lay in. You can just lay there and listen to the water. You can lay on your stomach and watch the water, watch the fish. The hull is the main structure that sits in the water. It's what gives the boat its buoyancy. Within the hull on this boat, you have two hulls because it's a catamaran.
Even with some waves and a few bumps, it's still a really leisurely ride.
And that's where the living accommodation is. That's where the washroom is, the shower room. You'll see it's a full double bed, and we've got four of those. We give people a lot of comfort when they're on a boat like this. On this side, it's where the galley is, where they do the cooking to prepare the food. The masts are what you use to hoist the sails. All of the sails are attached to the mast at some point. The jib is a very important sail, particularly if you want to sail into the wind.
Getting that last little bit of the sail up was pretty tough. Put these babies to work.
Mainsail, as its name suggests, is where the main power source is normally on a boat. That sail is usually the largest on the boat, and it is designed to keep the boat going as fast as possible. The stern of the boat is the back end of the boat, which gives us direction and keeps us going in towards our destination.
And if you want a place to chill with the open water by your side, there's no better place to head than for the deck.
So because we've got space, we've got big bean bags like this, which you can just sit on, enjoy, lay back, watch the view.
But for me, this is the best seat in the house, where you take things into your own hands and head out into the horizons. So I basically have a 12-ton machine at the palm of my hands, cruising through the water. That doesn't sound dangerous at all for me. I think I'm missing the mark.
To me, time is a luxury. You get on a yacht and suddenly you've got time. You've got time to observe. You've got time to see Mother Nature.
It's sailing tradition that once the sun starts to go down, you have to consume a glass of rum. Yes, I said rum. In a planet made up of three-fourths water and in an archipelago with a big stretch of it, there is no better way to reach your destination than in a yacht, where luxury and excitement meet. Now it's off to the next adventure.